Translating software without comments from your developers, but also screenshots, can be very difficult for your translators. That's why it's very important to provide both when you're translating your UI. So today I'm going to show you how you can automate both using Crowdin Context Harvester CLI. This is the application that uses AI to analyze your code to generate comments. And also we are going to use InContext tool to automatically grab all the screenshots from the application and send both into Crowdin. So this is basically the setup, right? So we are going to use Context Harvester for comments. We're going to scan the code, generate comments into a CSV so we can have a look how it actually looks like. And then we are going to upload that to Crowdin. And we are going to do the same for screenshots. So we are going to use Playwright to grab all the screenshots automatically and upload them to our Crowdin project. So, and we have both comments and screenshots available to translators inside Crowdin translation editor. So I'm going to talk about both tools very quickly, and then I'm going to show you how the setup looks like. And on at the end, I'm going to show you the demo. Okay, so this is the website we are going to use for testing. Very simple website. So first of all, let's talk about Context Harvester CLI. This app uses AI to analyze your code and automatically generate all the comments from your code. Obviously, the moment you are going to mention this to your security team, they are not going to be happy, but this is an open source package, right? So you can analyze the whole code, and also you can use any AI that you are using, right? So as you can see, there are a few different options, so you can pick whatever you want. So first, you install the package itself. If you want to install this locally, you can just copy and paste this into your terminal. Then you will need a key from your LLM provider. And you can use configure to set it up, or you can just copy and paste this and provide all the information, right? So you will need token from Crowdin. You will need an URL to your Crowdin setup. You will need a project ID, and also you'll have to choose which AI you are going to use to extract all of these, right? And this is what you need just to test it, right? You can test it locally, but eventually the idea is to implement it into your CI/CD pipeline, right? So you can do this with simple automation, right? Or you can use this inside your GitHub Actions or GitLab CI/CD and basically upload all the comments together with new strings to Crowdin. Now in Context tool. So first you will have to enable this inside your project. So obviously you will need to have a project with strings first. You go to tools and then we go to in context for web and you have to enable this. A few steps that you have to follow first. You have to make sure that you pick a pseudo language that is not available in your project, right? So basically, and just make sure that you're not going to use this language and you can just use this one. Then you have to download your translations. Obviously, if you are going to test it locally, you have to download this locally on the whole bundle. But obviously you can use CLI to automatically synchronize all your assets. So once that is done, the only thing that is left, you have to copy this script into header of your application to enable in context for your app. Then we have few more things to do automated screenshot management. We already set up in context. And now we have to enable a couple of different things. So first we have to enable 2FA for Crowdin first, and then we have to disable device verification. And then we also have to generate secret key, and we are going to use Playwright library to automatically go through our application. If you are using Playwright already, it's going to be very easy for you, because then the only thing you have to do is to basically enable screenshot capturing when you're going through your application, right? So if you're already using it for your automated tests, you can just enable this. But if you don't have any automated tests yet, you'll have to ask your engineers to create them before you can grab all the screenshots. But this is really it, what you need to do. So now let me show you how it actually works. Okay, as you can see, the same command that I showed you before, right? We are using Context Harvester. What's going to do, it's going to log in into your Crowdin project, pull all the strings, and it's going to try to find all your strings inside your code base and generate all the comments for you using LLM that you picked. I think I'm going to stop this. So now, once that is done, we can also run our screenshots, and I can show you how the output looks like from the context harvester. So the output from the context harvester looks like this. Very simple. We have keys, we have all the source strings, and we have context comments that were generated by LLM, right? Depending on which LLM you're going to pick, obviously you might get different results, but this is how it looks like. And when that is done, obviously we can upload all our comments into our project. I already did that, so I don't have to do this. Okay, so as you can see, this is done. We have all the screenshots inside Crowdin. So now we can go to our Crowdin project. So let's open Chinese. As you can see, we do see context that was generated by LLM, and we do have screenshot that was automatically generated by Playwright and automatically uploaded to our Crowdin project. So yeah, this is how it looks like, right? As I showed you, right, you can test it locally first, but once you see that this actually works, you can integrate Context Harvester into your CI/CD pipeline, and you can also integrate automated screen shooting into either your testing or part of your process and upload all of that together into your Crowdin project. Let me know if you have any questions.